Alright peeps, welcome back to another episode of Ex-Patron Fullcraft. That is right. So, you're probably wondering where on earth I am, and why I've got purple boots. The latter is that I found a slime island, and I made myself some slime boots and a slime sling. And secondly, I have been exploring for a better base location. As you can see, we're about 3,000 blocks away. I've been using the slime sling and the boat that's just there to explore. And I found two things over here. Firstly, I found you. If this is Enderium, then this is going to be... No, it's Resonant Ender. That's so close, though. Enderium blend. Alright, put you there. Yeah, things teleport with Enderium. Or Resonant Ender, I should say, but there's something else over here. Which is a inventory pet dungeon. Now, in case you didn't know, there is the inventory pets mod in this pack. As you can see right here, all sorts of different funky little things that you can create or find as loot to then get special effects and stuff like that. So this right here, this little formation right there, you see how the sand kind of comes out and is this little square thing with kind of some blocks missing? This indicates that there's a dungeon down here. As you can see, there is a chest in here. Let us go ahead open the chest. Now, there is a cave spider spawner in here, so we have to be careful. We get a magma cube pet! And then we know we're drowning. Let's just grab the torch. Refresh our oxygen. And head back out. So that is how you find inventory pets. There's this dungeon. You can find them on tops of trees, like the regular vanilla oak trees. And you can also find them underground in special dungeons. And, of course, you can find them in the clouds. There are special cloud blocks that you can find where you pillar up and then loot them. And there are four legendary pets. This right here is a mob pet. So it's based on a mob. As you can see, we get fire resistance and walk on lava, favorite food, nether quartz. So when one of these pets is on your hotbar and you have the food in your inventory, it will give you whatever it says on it. So if we had this on our hotbar, like so, as you can see, we get fire resistance too. I don't know why it's two, but forever. And we can walk on lava. Yeah. So that is indeed a thing. We also have many, many buckets of water, which what I'm going to go ahead and do is empty them all. So we can go like this. So, because the buckets will be useful and we can smelt them down if we need extra iron. But I don't think we need this many water buckets on us currently. There we go. And actually, we'll just do this. Yeah, I'm out here exploring. I'll go ahead and put some stuff in here. As you can see, I looted another slime island and a minecart chest in a thing. That's what they're called, in the mine shafts. That's it. And we got sponges as well. That's going to be actually really, really useful for tinkers and for these dungeons in the future. I don't know what you are, but not really going to bother looking. But, so far on the map, as you can see, I've been over this way. I found a biome that looked quite good. I can't remember which one it was. I think it was this one. This, like, foresty type place with the village right there. I looted that island, as you can see, it's kind of a bit barren now. I didn't loot that one, although I probably should have, because that, I think, is purple. I think, I'm not sure. But yeah, I'm out here and I will continue exploring. Ooh, what are you? Cows abound! And I abound too. Okay, what are you? Liquid experience! Ooh! You're quite cool, although, must say, once we get any experience farm, it's kind of pointless. We cannot now get rid of this. It has a temperature. Ew, that's interesting. Anyway, I guess we're going to have to keep that in our inventory, considering we cannot get rid of it. Well, I guess you're a thing. And chunk errors. Nice. Lots of chunk errors, actually. Indeed. I guess I'll go this way then. That's water there. And this is, I guess not here. Reload the chunks. Where's my... Yeah, look, the memory's going through the roof. Like, I was told to set it to 5 GB, but I prefer to set it to about 6. Modded Minecraft. Alright, so we've got like a regular savanna over there, and then this is an outback, I do believe, over here. Oh, a Hermitron! I guess I'll keep you peeps with me for a little bit while I explore. Let's see what we get. Ooh, Shrew, Slime, Amy, Corey, and Hops. Well, that's good. We've now got a second Hermitron box that we can transport items with. The fluid cow. And another ocean over that way. Let's continue. Ooh, a pine forest. I like biomes aplenty. It makes things much more interesting when you go exploring. And another Hermitron. Yeah, this is fur. Let's see what we get. We get an uncommon. Quasat. Fluora. Expert dio tree and poppers. What I'm actually going to do is store all of the Hermitrons in one, like a so, so we can keep an eye on them. Then that's that one. That's that one. Nice. We have 3 of the boxes now. I guess we'll continue through the forest. There's some more. Some sheep. Some more sheep. Is that another one? No, it's some flowers. Anytime I see colour, I'm like, ooh, a Hermitron. But no, not this time. Framey. Why is it so framey? Right, we have a blue slime island up there. That isn't worth it. And another one right over there. A lava pit. And prime slime sling territory. Ooh, one of those biomes. Another slime one up there. Ooh, the 3 right there. Purple one, blue one, and then another purple one. I'm talking about the trees on top, by the way, not the color of the islands. It's always opposite. So the green ones will have purple trees, the purple ones will have blue trees. Or I guess green trees as well, but yeah, I think it's just blue trees. All right, so this is the Mystic Grove biome. I think, yeah, the memory's going. I'm gonna have to restart the game again, which is a shame. I think I'll just set the gigabytes to 6, because 5 and under, it just doesn't work for me. But I'll go ahead and lag, it seems, and, yeah, look at this, like, purple water. It's amazing. I like biomes aplenty. Alright. Guess I'll just continue over this way and freeze in the middle of the air. Because why wouldn't you? And also, this is more good places to find the inventory pets. On these beaches. I don't see any just around here. I was quite lucky to find that one. Yeah. And again! The slime sling is super useful for exploring. But apart from when it does that, so this here, right here, is here, right here, yes. These regular oak trees will have a random chance of having a chest at the top of them. Like, in the topmost branches, like, or the topmost log tree bit and tiger wood. And in those you can find the inventory pets and random loot as well from the inventory pets mod. And as I mentioned, there are four legendary pets. There's the slime pet, which you can only find in the trees. There's the cloud pet, which you can only find in the clouds. There's the... oh, what is it called? It is this one. The black hole pet. That's another legendary. And then there's the pufferfish pet, which is only found in the beach dungeons. So I'm going to be on the lookout for these pet dungeons as I go. Another fluid cow right there. Keep an eye in the sky for the cloud ones as well. It would be easier if I turned the clouds off and then looked around, because then I'd be able to spot them much easier. So that is indeed what I will do. Let's just head round. Oh, head round the edge here. No, nothing else. Ooh, all the different things. I don't suppose you'll be ready to know. Neither will you. But they are here. That is for sure. Do this. Put that back there. So yes. The magma cube pet will be useful when we go to the Nether, because we can feed it there, and also walking on lava. I mean, that's a game changer right there. We'll just be able to walk straight across the lava lakes, no need to for flight or anything. I wonder if the slime sling would work with that. If I, like, slimed up into the air and then landed on lava, would it bounce me? You know, like, bounce off the lava? That would be amazing. Super cheaty way of doing things. Birch over there. Purple cow. Yeah, there is a purple cow pet as well. Is this a dungeon? This is a dungeon! We found another dungeon, peeps! good grief. I was like, this, what, this here looks suspicious. I need to sleep. Can't sleep on thin air. Yes, I know. That would be a magic carpet right there. Alright. There we go. Now, we will see what is down here. Hoi! We get it. I can't get in there. The Illuminati pet! That one is amazing! That one is amazing. That one costs a Nether Star to make right there. This one is a YouTuber pet designed by Lachlan. I used to watch him, but I don't anymore. But it spawns a random item, right click. True invisibility for 1 minute, sneak and right click. 2 minute cooldown, favorite fruit, emerald nugget. So, with this one, what we do is we put it here, right? If we sneak right click, it does that, and we are 100% invisible for about a minute. So this is the ultimate pranking pet. Like, look, we can you even see the? No, you can see the running particles, but just walking around, like, it's a thing. Yeah. Yeah, like none of the armor, nothing, and then random item. Oh, it's on cooldown. I guess you can only do either or. The invisibility or the random item. Not both at once. But anyway, that is a very, very good find, as you can see right there. That's the regular invisibility, but that's with the Illuminati pet. And it can be anywhere on a hotbar. And there it goes. Finishing the invisibility there. Alright. More water. Turn it into fresh water. Let's just go ahead and get rid of it. Once again. Get rid of the sand. The water down there. And we should be good to continue. And we can also now see what this cow is! What are you? Eat. What are you? You, oh, molten silver. I don't know why it's purple when it's silver, but cool, I guess. We don't really need silver, so Yeah. Whatever, I guess. It was weird, like, the, I found an iron one as well that was also purple. Anyway, let's continue over here. Have a look for any more pet dungeons. The sand ones are the easiest to... Whoa. Are the easiest to find, because they kind of stand out on the edge of these sandy biomes here, or the sandy beaches. But the Illuminati pit, definitely a very, very good find. I'm super pleased with that. Is that one over there? I can't tell. Also, look at those coral things under the water there. Really illuminating. Illuminati-ing the what's it noodles, the oceans. Alright, there's nothing really over here. But we're once again in one of these biomes. Now, something we could do is just chop down every single tree, trying to find the pets, rather than kind of looking at each tree. But I think that would be a bit much, you know? Just destroying forests. Well, this is a nice biome. Orchard. This is a really nice biome. Yeah, with this, like, bright green, but it isn't too bright. Ooh, ooh. I saw it, there's a cloud pet up there. Well, not a cloud pet, but a cloud pet, an inventory pet's cloud dungeon. If it's a cloud pet, then that is going to be amazing, but I doubt it will. Let's go ahead, head up, and over here, see if we can get up there. I guess we could break this and use wood to get up there, although I do have a bunch of dirt, but seeing as this is here, we will do that. And then turn a bunch of this into planks. And then, where's a good spot? It's over this way. And you can't see them on the map either, which is interesting. Illuminati pet ready. Let's see what random item we get! Mana Lens Messenger. Yeah, it's anything. Anything at all. So, that was useful at this point in time. Totally, yes. Also, we now have 17 sponges, I've just noticed. Right, let's head up right about here, I think. Shield, go away. Now, there are blaze spawners on these things, but weirdly, the cave spiders and... Like, the cave spiders weren't spawning in those, sand dungeons. So, and like, from watching, the Hermit's videos of Fullcraft, I haven't seen any blaze spawn either on these ones. But there is a chest up there, so this one has not been raided yet. We are finding prime petness. Alright, we're nearly there. Let's continue up with our derpy wood tower. Alright. Now, it doesn't really matter if we fall off because of the slime stuffs. We get the grave pet! Restores inventory after death. That's pretty good. Let's go ahead. Oops. Okay, I guess they're going there. Let's put all the pets in one, I think. That makes sense. All the pet stuff. Oh, your favorite food is bones. So, restores inventory after death. That sounds a bit like keep inventory to me. So, I guess we would use that. Oh, another quartz as well now. So, we can use this. Let's get rid of this. Now, you have to silk touch these blocks to actually get them. Let's go ahead. Put these things away in here. Is there anything that can go in here? Not really. We have snowballs now, I guess. Put the shield back. Pick up these. So it looks like when you right-click on one of these blocks, it'll swap out the block for that. And also, these are like x-ray blocks. So at some point, we might want to come back here now that I think about it. Just look, we need to silk touch it. See? I'll tell you what we could do. Oh, this is a brilliant idea. Hold on. No! Oh... Because we've got fortune on this thing, we can't, make it self-touch, but we could make another pickaxe and make it self-touch with the sponge. So I guess we could do that, like, right now. If we make some patterns, right? I know this is a bit wasteful, but what we could do is make all of the tinker stuff again. Right, I already had a tool station, that makes sense. That was a waste. We need this. We need this. Sure. So let's make pickaxe head, tool rod, and a binding. And then we will make, we'll grab some cobble. Need at least three. We will make a head, we will make one of these, and then we will make the tool rod out of sponge. Which gives it squeaky. And if you remember from Hermit Pack, this will give us a Silk Touch Pickaxe. The problem is, it says mining harvest level obsidian. Is there anything on us that would be able to mine obsidian? Let's see here. There's a diamond. Wouldn't really want to use a diamond up on that. Nothing in there. We have one obsidian nugget. Can we make... What's the harvest level on slime? Mining level stone, that doesn't work. I mean, we could put the diamond on it, but I don't want to put the diamond on it because that would be a waste of a modifier. Oh, this is such a dilemma right here. Because there is literally no point in putting the diamond on there and wasting a modifier. But it would mean we'd be able to mine it. Like, is there anything we can use ice for? In terms of tool materials, I don't think so. And I'm not completely derping, am I? No. And like, we can't swap that out. Yes. Modifier look cannot be combined with silk, with enchantment silk touch, so that isn't a thing either. Let me just check if I make this, because we'll want a silk touch pick at some point anyway. Look, see now? We can't mine it. We could, of course, do this. We could make it a mining level diamond. That isn't even obsidian level. I don't know, it's a puzzle. It really is, because, like, what do we do? Like, honestly, what do we do now? Because we can't leave here and come back. Anything around us? No. What does this cost? Ender nugget. We don't have an ender nugget, no. Oh, the house pet would have been perfect, and we have one gold, one diamond, the wood, but we don't have an ender nugget. Fail. Oh, is there any pet that we could make that would help us? That pet. We could make the... the chicken pet, right? No, I only have one feather. Pac-Man pet, we'd have a cookie. Cheetah pet. Silverfish pet. Wolf pet. Shield pet. Hot pet. Moon pet. Dubstep pet. Juggernaut pet. Mickerson, Purplicious Cow, can we make that iron diamond? Oh, no, we can't make that either.
Well, peeps, I think this is a slight fail right here. We can't mine the clouds. So I'm going to just have to put away some of this stuff that we don't necessarily need on us at this current moment. So, sure, I'll just put away all of this, seeing as we don't really need it on us. Dirt goes in there, and then we pick these up and we say, oh well, I guess, you know, and this stuff will fall to the ground because there's nothing under it, but we'll pick it up after. And yeah, I mean, we could leave this here and then ladder up at some point, or we could just break it all and say be done with it and what have you. So that's indeed what I'm going to do. We are going to vein mine our way down, and one day we'll come back or find a different cloud, and then get the cloud blocks, and then we will be able to see through the world. It's just a shame that we couldn't do it just now, because that's how you find the black hole pet. Is you get the cloud blocks and then you put them on the ground and you look underground, and when you see like the dungeon, that's when you that's when you go for it, you know? Like, you dig down and you get it that way. Or can we have these things, just get these trees out of the way, because I was just making sure that we didn't have things lying on the ground over here, such as tool station forge. What's its, yeah, that was a real shame. I mean, we could have used the diamond, but there was literally no point, and it would have ruined the tool and it would have been a waste of a sponge. But we do have a silk pick now, even though technically we don't really need our damn you cloud. Anyway, I'll either continue exploring or I might leave it there. I don't know. Like, I'm kind of thinking that maybe we could move into this biome. Oh, there's a dungeon there that I didn't see before. Let's head back that way. This way, was it? I presume it's this way. No, it's that way. Alright. Ugh, stupid lag thing. Yeah, I think this biome is where we're going to set up our base. It's nice and airy and light and, you know, isn't too overwhelming. I mean, I guess it's a bit bright, but it's relatively flat, and some saplings on the ground, and it has this dungeon thing over here. Very good. just got that achievement. Right, let's see. What are you? Protection 2 and Depth Strider, some emeralds, and some other stuff. Those emeralds will be useful. I will grab this. And I'll also grab the redstone torch. Very good. Oh, I can't resist saying that now. Right, I'm not sure if there's any spawners under these, but it's meant to be like a graveyard type dungeon type thing. Oh, and the snow here as well. Or is this the fur? No, this is the fur, I see. Okay. Well, this is a cool area. Got this, like, ravine with then this kind of cliff thing going on. Let me just go ahead. Slime sling up here. I kind of want to see what's over in this side over here. Just to see. It kind of just continues over this way, the biome. Alright. And another of these, like, hole things. Cool, I guess. And then at this side, we've got a marsh, I think. There's a chance cube. I guess while we're here, we may as well open it. I'll go ahead and put some things away first. I guess it can be the end of episode chance cube
see, anything can go away, you can go away. Let's put paper and those away, and then all of that away. And I guess we'll put all of these things away too. Sure. Alright, Chance Cube, what are you going to be? Bookshelves. Nice. Thank you. Anyway, peeps, I think that's going to do it for today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. A bit of exploring around. Pink Sheep. You know, one of the mods must add this, because we had this in Izumanati 2.0, the Pink Sheep, the random Pink Sheep. Hi. Yes, and there's another one. And another one. And they're all by... Look. One Pink Sheep, three White Sheep. One Pink Sheep, two White Sheep. One Pink Sheep, two White Sheep. Three White Sheep, actually. And then one Pink Sheep, two or three White Sheep. There's something going on here. It's a conspiracy. Anyway, as I mentioned, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, make sure to go ahead and hit that like button. Can you all shut up? Hit that like button down below and show your support. Comment if you wish, subscribe if you have not already. And I will see you all in the next episode. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.